Namaste, Justice Chandru. Welcome. Thank you for accepting the interview. That Jai Bhim title and the Jai Bhim concept that you, with all your Marxist insights and leanings and study, you added that, even your book also says that.
That is because there are two issues are there. The title of the film, when it is made into several languages, all four southern language plus Hindi, it should not have a Tamil title.
Yes.
It should have a pan-India title.
Oh.
So this title was with some other director who was willingly gave the title.
Okay.
So to some extent, the success of the film depends on the title.
Yes.
It, everybody now says Jai Bhim.
Yes.
Only scheduled caste people are saying. Today, non-scheduled caste people, common people are saying Jai Bhim. Whenever anybody sees me, they call me Jai Bhim. So
yeah.
I am very proud because the title also brought some success to the film. Secondly, this film also contains not only a Marxist understanding of tribal liberation, but also some redemption, like literacy.
Yeah.
Literacy being a liberating factor.
Yes, yes, yes.
That mother was giving thumb impression, daughter reading newspaper. So it is reminded, learn, educate, and agitate. That's Ambedkar's famous quotation.
Learn,
so that
educate,
that was the theme.
Yeah.
In fact, that last scene where a girl reading a newspaper, that is used in CPM party posters in Kerala. Because it appeals.
Yeah.
Literacy is not yours or mine. It should go to them. And that scene has a mass appeal. Therefore, even a political party is using that. Nothing wrong. It's a universal concept.
But it's a political success of sorts that the land of Dravidian ideology has shown both the Ambedkar and Marx and hammer and sickle in such a limelight after a long
political
time.
Philosophy,
yes.
If it is dogmatic, it is not successful.
Yeah.
It should be pragmatic. So India has a unique factor of caste. You are having a doctrine of class doctrine. Today, you should also have an introspect that you should you develop added ideas of caste. And you should have also have Ambedkar, one of the principal theorists on caste and religion in India. So in my judgments, I have quoted extensively Ambedkar. When I published as a book, I said, my judgments in the light of Ambedkar. Some people said, how you can have a judgment? I said, it is a fact that you cannot decide religion and caste without Ambedkar.
Yeah.
And I've used it extensively, therefore I am acknowledging nothing wrong in that. And therefore, as a Marxist perspective, you should also understand Ambedkar. You can't write off.
Sir, in this connection, much is said about your differences at some point with CPIM. In fact, for me, I read about it, the conversation between EMS Nambudripad and we are Krishnayar also. It is crystal clear that your differences are nothing personal or something. They are just some kind of policy matter, we may say.
Always differences and cannot be personal, sir. Difference has to be policy.
Yeah.
You work with the organization to the extent that your policy also accept.
Yeah.
Suppose that you have a difference, you have a different charter.
Yeah.
After CPM, I will not join any political party.
You have nothing against that.
A man is a political person, whether you are in a party or not.
Yeah.
In fact, somebody called me comrade, and then they were hesitant. I said, comrade is not a brand name for any party.
Yeah.
Comrade is a comrade. That's
all. Okay, okay. But to conclude my first part, sir, a lot of people, Indians, developed a lot of adoration and admiration for you. They know, legal community knows about you, because when you retired, all the law magazines gave quite extensive interviews, insights about you. And then this film further made you an icon and a star. Now, with this kind of propaganda and this kind of unseemly controversy,
one thing I tell you, India is a vast country.
Yeah.
Coastal Andhra is not India.
Yeah.
And I find politics so polarized, there is no space for objective views.
Yeah.
Any third party, neutral people say something, somebody has to criticize them.
Yeah.
Rather than welcoming.
Yeah.
So it is a very unfortunate situation. Political intolerance lead to such criticism.
That's why
you should ignore those criticism.
My question is that, okay, we ignore the intolerant criticism or motivated criticism, But what is your message or communication to the vast people who admire and actually like you so much and feel disturbed by this kind of...
Good work should lead to further good work.
Yeah.
And if this film has got a message, many youngsters are asking that we feel guilty that such people are living among us. Please tell us what we should do. People who are below 30 years, raw youngsters, looking for guidance to do social work for a community development. So if we are able to lead them, show them some way where they could also participate, where the excluded societies are becoming inclusive society, that's the greatest victory for a social change.
So we should strive for an inclusive society.
Yes.
But the point is that the CGI is on record. Nowadays, student movements are not producing great leaders. But you are sitting before us. You are a product of 70s, we may say, 60s. How do you agree with that? Whether
that
agreeing,
not
disagreeing,
corrected.
Not with him, but in general.
That's not correct that today there are no good leaders. There are good leaders and always there is always good leaders and bad leaders.
Okay.
But today's youth undergo much more stress and much more complex society than it was to be.
Yeah.
We were rather a simple society. There are less complications were there. Today, these complex issues will have to be addressed. Like you have a IT professional having a meeting. Technology.
Yeah.
Technology for whom? Therefore, that is the issue. Complex problem requires complex solutions.
Yeah.
Therefore, you should come up with new solutions.
Yeah.
And I think the present day youth are admirable in their world attitude. Today one film can make them to speak on this issue.
Yeah.
Imagine they're looking forward for such opportunities. That has to be tapped.
Mm.
Those talents have to be tapped.
But in fact, political leadership is failing in them, we may say.
Our country looks for avatars.
Ah.
And therefore, a lot of personality cult. I think it will evolve where the social movement will find its own leaders also.
On the other day, the Prime Minister was in Kasi taking Ganga to... the opposition, or what do you say, largest opposition party leader saying that India must be ruled by Hindus rather than Hindutva.
That is why the word secularism in constitutional preamble is more important. You can't forget what it means.
Yeah.
It has a meaning and purpose.
Yeah.
And Supreme Court said preamble is a basic structure of the constitution.
Mm.
So if somebody works against that, BJP party in their constitution also saying they are a secular party.
Mm.
But then now what is the secularism means? Does it mean the majority party, majority religion, or providing space for every religion in this country? Should the state interfere or stay away from religion? Article 25 talks about freedom of religion and right to profess any religion of their choice. The choice cannot come from government.
Yes.
It has to come from... Now we find so many laws are being brought, religious conversion law, then what you should eat, what you should pray, and whether you are praying, you should say some other slogan. All this is, we are pushing this country to a very sectarian path.
Yes.
Which is not good for this country. Whole world is laughing at this country. So therefore, we should redeem that it is a secular republic and not a...
Justice Chandra referred, you are repeating this word, secular. On the other day, when Rajya Sabha debated this question of enhancing the pension of retired judges, one member particularly referred that certain judges are making statements which are not secular from their bench. Actually, on religious matters and all these things.
Even last week, Sitaram Yechury should be initiated.
Yes, John Bridas
was
telling.
The judge at the time of accepting office, he takes a oath under Schedule 3, I will uphold the constitution without fear or favor. What is the meaning of the constitution?
Yeah.
India is a sovereign, socialist, democratic republic.
Yes.
Secular republic. Now, if you speak against secularism, certainly he should be sent out of In fact, there was one judge from Gujarat, Patidar. He said because of reservation, India has gone backward.
Yes.
Then he withdrew that remark.
Yes.
So there must be a public criticism of such judges, which Sitaram Yechury correctly said that this man action should be initiated. That is correct.
But this question of public criticism of judges, are treating judiciary as a sacred and holy cow above criticism. That is one major point of contention nowadays in Indian politics. Two points of view. One is that government intruding into the judicial sovereignty. Second thing is judiciary itself overstepping, or how do you balance?
Always there is a cross-border terrorism. Each divided areas, they are not...
Popular. Judicial activism, I may say.
Therefore, if suppose the judiciary oversteps, behaves like a third chamber, it can be corrected by law. For example, the SCST Act, Supreme Court struck down SCST Act, new provisions for victims. Parliament amended it. Another bench upheld the parliamentary amendment. Therefore, it is an ongoing process. Judges can be criticized. Constitution gives provision for that. Contempt of court says truth is a defense. Therefore, the judges are not beyond criticism. Okay. Judges cannot act, they are sitting in an ivory tower.
Yes.
But parliament members also must be stick to the constitution, which says you should not step in and interfere with the judicial function.
Okay.
Criticism is different. Interfering the functioning. Now what is happening is interference.
Yes.
Transferring judges. You take a acting chief justice.
Yes.
Transfer to Punjab as number 9.
Yes.
Then why don't you say it's a victimization? It's not a routine transfer. If a man is number 1 here, comes from an illustrious family of judges, and then say he's number 9 in Punjab. People want to know transparency. Yes. So judiciary cannot act an autonomous republic. It has also to answer the people. So whenever there is a stepping out of their assigned territory, it should be corrected.
Tamil Nadu CJ Banerjee suddenly transferred after giving a few adverse judgments in the view of the
I wrote an article on
You wrote person. An article on Hindu. Similarly,
Bombay... People would like to know because he was heading a court of 75 judges. Now he sent to Meghalaya where there are 4. Actually, there are only 2 judges are there. Then why, I won't say it's a demotion. I will only say that when a man comes from a chartered high court to another chartered high court, at that time there was a selection. Now suddenly within 10 months, when there is COVID, when there is a close down of courts, the virtual courts alone functioning, how did you find anything wrong with him? We would like to know the background of that transfer. If the background is on some other reason, then we would like to know.
Yeah.
And if it is based on extraneous reason, it should go also.
Justice Chandru, thank you very much that
thank you sir. Thank
explained
you.
So many things, and people still adore you and expect much from you in the area of judiciary, where a lot of stress and strain are going on, particularly Telugu lands. And
these are all only momentary.
Momentary,
Only good things will finally win.
Yeah.
Bad things will be lost.
That's right. Thank you.